Okay.
Here we go. Second video of July 6th. Tuesday. Yeah. Like you said, this is the first one. I think we're both a bit tired of it.
Yeah.
And very lack of sleep, insomnia issues, among other things.
Yeah.
But
warming up.
But we push ourselves. We make ourselves work. You know, we do it. We don't. If we feel bad, we it doesn't matter. We get up and we work anyway.
Yeah, we keep pushing towards the goal here.
We don't let nothing hold us back.
That's right.
Balls to the wall.
Balls to the wall. Speaking of that, I have that written down on paper. You see on the last video, balls to the wall.
Yep. we're cranking up to balls to the wall at speed. That's for sure, and the thing we do, you know, that's what we're trying to do, you know, no more messing around, no more of this, you know, no more laziness, you know, and doing things slow, you know.
Right. Trying to keep on track here, you know.
We got so much that needs to be done, and we're kind of happy to be doing it. We're getting things rolling finally. But I thought it's something we could answer. It was a question. This guy, Jerry, that was referred to me on Facebook this morning to someone else. He does websites and does writing. But then he wrote this morning, Jerry had written me to ask what how do we define spirituality? Because he's like, well, there's so many different ways to define it. How can we define what we do? You know, like our specific spiritual path, you know. And I think maybe the good way to put it is that the first thing we do, you know, is that we go through other spiritual paths of other people and look at what other people have done and take the good, what we can use out of that and discard the non-useful stuff for us. I know I do that.
And we kind of put ourselves in the mental path of these other spiritual to give us an idea of what we find good in it and what we find bad in it, go with our hearts, you know.
And that's right. Some of the stuff we do is just, a lot of it just comes from our heart and soul. It doesn't come from any book or form of stuff that's been said before. It's stuff that's come to mind, you know, that's coming to us from the infinite. You know, it's kind of hard to describe exactly what we do. Like, that's a good way to put it. I think that, you know, we have many different beliefs, you know, but all our beliefs come down to doing good for others, and it comes down to just a few things. Showing love to others, compassion to others is almost on top of everything.
It's a good question. At the same time, there's no real perfect way to answer that question. You know,
I was thinking the same thing.
Yeah, like,
it's hard to answer.
You know, anything anybody says, you know, what is their spiritual path, should be accepted, you know, as a spiritual path. Now, understandable may not be necessarily, you know, everybody may not understand everybody's path, but acceptable is definitely, you should accept, even if their path is to, you know, walk backwards down a hill or something, you know, that was their path, but, you know, that's okay.
Yeah, that's good. You know, gotta respect others.
Yeah.
You know, respect others' paths.
Yeah, definitely.
But respecting their paths doesn't mean that you can, you know, let them know if they're about to walk into a tree case first,
exactly.
So to speak. You know, you can bring stuff to their awareness, though. There's nothing wrong with that.
No,
that's not disrespectful. You know, if their spiritual path takes them into a tree and they're blind, so and they can't see where they're going, that you can then extend, you know, help in hand and give them some suggestions.
Right.
That's a analogy to what we do, maybe, is that we're just trying to maybe be some kind of lantern, light up a certain way, suggest a certain idea, certain ways for people to go, you know?
That's right. Just light up the path of, you know, whichever path, you know, necessary for them to go on. Maybe we can be the light to show the correct path for you or your friends or your family to go on. You know, we're trying to say go with your heart, the goodness in your heart, what's good, you know, like follow what's good in the Bible and in different books of religion. Follow what's good in what people say, you know, the way your family say, don't, you know, if it feels bad and negative to you, just don't try to follow it, you know, try to find something else, you know.
Yeah, because if it feels bad and negative, it probably is for you at least. You know, it's not the path you're supposed to be on.
Right.
If something doesn't feel right, then don't do it. If it feels wrong within your inner self, inner soul, within you, and you just feel like fidgety or around a certain thing, doing certain things, or feel a little depressed doing it, or
that's how I feel.
You can't do it. Shouldn't do it.
A lot of people say you have to be a good Christian or believer in Christ, you have to go to church. One place I feel uncomfortable, and no offense to any churches or anything, any type of churches or religious beliefs, but I feel uncomfortable in church.
Yeah.
So I don't go to church, you know. It's just it's one of the things, I don't feel comfortable with that.
Like, church never made sense to me. I could touch on that too. When I was a kid, like 7, 8 years old, I remember going there and my mom going to church every Sunday, and I'm like, I don't want to go to church. It's just not any use.
Yeah, it's like, oh.
I listen to the stuff sometimes, and I'd be like, this stuff makes no sense. You know, I just knew a lot of it was just not true. You know, lots of stuff has been just made up by humans over the years and thrown into books like the Bible and other things.
Speaking of the Bible, I mean, at the time I was very gung-ho about Christianity. I mean, my first experience in the church was my own idea, you know, as a child saying, okay, I'm going to go to church now. And my mom going, why, you know? And me saying, well, let's see what it's like, you know? And it never really, like I said, there's, like you just said, there's a lot of things in there that don't seem, even as a small child, that seem kind of combobulated over the years, you know. And you know the difference. You just don't want to say it because you don't want to be offensive, or you want to be non-Christian or something, or whatever it is, you know. But it's not non-Christian to see the good in Christianity.
Yeah. It's not wrong, like, to go through the Bible, for example, and just pick out only verses that you feel are have a true truth in yourself, that your psychic intuition tells you are based on fact, not fiction.
Yeah, and, words will jump out that are applicable for you, you know.
Oh, yeah. You know, they'll come out instantly. You don't even have to think about it.
Yeah.
Like we touched on it, use your first impression.
Intuition.
I've done that before, and you can just scan. It's real fast. It's one page, takes 10 to 15 seconds, 20 seconds scanning. How many, but really, just in the words will just pop out to me. This stuff is really true. There's no, you know.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely the same with all religious beliefs, you know.
I'll have to say that.
Yeah, that kind of answers the question of what kind of spiritual path we're on. I mean, it means, you know, we're on a path of finding the good and what's supposed to be good, you know.
Yeah, finding a way to light up the good in people, point out the good that's within others, and, you know, take away the bad, you know, lessen the bad, show people the good within themselves, show people that they're all right. Yeah, that's what we like to do. I enjoy doing stuff like that.
Help, healing, and hope.
Yeah, a good way to put it. Yeah.
Three ages.
Yeah, help, heal, man. But I'm going to write that down, too.
Yeah.
Three ages. Yeah. But, you know, they have that 4-H club thing. I don't know how that came to mind. But you could have help, healing, hope, and happiness.
Yeah.
That came to mind, and it would become the 4 ages. Happiness makes sense, too.
Yeah, happiness.
But, help. When you help people, it's going to lead to spiritual healing, sexual healing, and other places of healing. And then when you're healed, your hope comes back.
Yeah.
You know, your hope for better life and knowing that it'll be better, and they know the hope for change is back again, and that hope becomes a reality next, and that is results in inner true happiness. See how it works.
Yeah, happiness almost becomes your intuition at that point. Your first impression of yourself after hope and healing and help is intuitionally happiness.
Yeah.